There's a well.
Don't turn back. You're getting close.
She could spend hours, days even, trapped within herself in the dark.
You see me?
Yes.
Your eyes were open, but you were gone.
And when it finally let her go, she could be anywhere, with no memory of how she got there.
When it comes for me, I have no power over it.
But here, for the first time, someone was there to help.
But I heard your voice. You brought me back.
You found your own way back. All you needed was a little help. A little hope.
What if this is pointless? What if you're wrong?
He's been fooled before and he could be fooled again.
You don't know. It's just their game for you.
You never know which way it's going to go.
I want to tell you a story about a god of the Northmen called Baldur. The second son of Odin, he was beautiful, good, and wise. He was fair of feature, he spoke fair words, he gave fair judgments. Light shone from him. Only good things were told of him. Yet he was the first of the gods to die.
this far. But the bridge is broken. There's no way you can fix it. What do you do now, Senua? You can feel it. You need the runes to fight Dillian. You need Dillian. He's waiting for you. He's close. He loves you. go through it.
It's dangerous.
Follow it. What's behind the gate?
Where will it take you? It's not safe.
Dillian.
There he is.
There he is.
What are you waiting for? Quick, find a way.
Find him.
Go through the door before he disappears.
Dillian, don't lose him.
Too many times.
You always let him disappear.
Dillian, there he is.
Quick.
Where is he?
Where's he gone?
We're in the wrong world.
He's not here.
She's in the wrong world.
He's not in this world.
He's in the other one. He's in the other one. He's in the dark world.
The dark.
The dark
world. The world once seemed so simple. Black and white. Darkness and light. Narrow dividing lines of our own making. Dillian taught her to see further. To peek through the cracks and see the worlds of colour stretching away from the gloom. And Senua explored new paths into the unknown.
Death, and the gods fear for his life. So Baldur's mother makes everything in the world. Fire, water, iron, stone, earth, wood, beasts, birds, serpents, poison, sickness. Swear an oath not to harm her son. One by one, they each make their vow. Neither weapons nor wood will injure him, Baldur's mother boasts. Only Loki, father of Hela, the mistress of death, is not amused.